Oh, radio, radio. Uh-huh. Oh, oh, oh,
radio,
radio.
What?
Radio. Yep. Happy. Boing.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back. This is George. Still working on this senior VoltOhmyst. And remember I told you that I thought it was the potentiometers that sat right here. Well, I've taken all those out, and I think I can show you for sure that it is these. As a matter of fact, you look right here, get something to point with, so it's my grubby finger. If you look right here, you can see there's not even any, there's no traces there. So there's a piece of a trace here, some here. This is the AC one that's in line with the problem I was having. You can look right here. These are somewhat corroded. That one's most likely what it should look like. But even the ends, where that corrosion got down in there, is bad. So those are definitely bad. These are the little caps that came off of it. And the backside is not much better on the AC one here. You can see that there's a little space there in between the runs. And there's really not much of a run left here on any of this. So these are definitely bad. I just got back from Radio Shack and I got these 10K ohm. The only thing that worries me is 50 volts. Radio Shack doesn't carry anything anymore with any voltage ratings on it, so I'm hoping these will work. They're only a buck and a half a piece, so we'll see. And ideally, I'd like to clean this out, cut these traces, and use these connectors to mount these on. That'll give me a nice stiff piece to mount them to, good solder points, and keep everything lined up. So that's the next step, is strip the rest of this old potentiometer off of here and put these new ones in place, see if we can make them work. So be back in a little while. Okay, here is how I fix these. I use the existing outer pins. The inner pin, since these the center one comes through the back, I brought the center pin through the back and jumped it down with a piece of wire where it would have gone. So now I've got the original housing. These are relatively well lined up. I think I'll be able to get through them through the adjustment holes. And now I'm fixing to just put it back on and see if it works. Okay, so I have these mounted back in here again. It's not a perfect fit, but it works just fine. It fits in there okay. That's what it looks like on the back. Now, key is, let's put it on negative. I'm putting on plus volts and the 1.5 volt scale. Oh yeah. Got lots and lots of deflection now. Let's go up in volts. Yep. Higher. Perfect. Higher. Oh, this is great. My only question is how long will these hold up with these in here? And it looks like it's perhaps the... Oh, no, it's all right. Okay, negative volts DC. Oh, yeah. Let's go up to the highest setting. Perfect. I mean, I can get deflection all the way across now, not just 60% or halfway. This is AC volts. Let's see. Yep. Go all the way down to the lowest scale. Yes, sir. Not full deflection, but... Okay. Well, that's good. I'll go through the rest of the tests now, like just the way Banderson TV did. I'll just step through the documentation and go through all the calibration tests and make sure I can calibrate it. And we'll come back with a final verdict. Okay, everybody, I've got it all back together. I've ordered some of that plastic cleaner. This needs a good clean now. It's got some, get some goof off and clean up the case, but the good news is electrically it works. The calibration procedure worked, and I had a problem in that I didn't have a probe. I had an old probe connector with just bare ends on the cable. The cable was really old. So I took that apart, and using the schematics here, just a 1 megohm with a single pole, single throw switch in parallel right across it to short it out. That was really easy to make, so I started looking around, and I took a Sharpie and made myself a probe. It's got a little, small little switch here, turn the short that resistor on and off. An old meter tip that I used. Let me open this up. Show you what it looks like. I was going to show you before I sealed it up. And that's it. Just a resistor right across the switch terminals to this deal here. And this is actually, I like this cable. This white cable is actually a 75 ohm cable, but you know the ground connection is through this extra lead here, so this is a single conductor anyway, so I didn't think the impedance really made a difference. But I'll tell you one thing that does make a difference when you're doing the DC calibration: you need to have this 1 megohm resistor in line, because it will throw the meter way off, well, not way off, but it'll throw it off 3 or 4%, maybe 5%. I noticed that. It looked like I wasn't going to be able to get the DC adjusted with a DC voltage, but as soon as I put this 1 meg resistor in line, I was able to have enough room to adjust it, so it worked fine. So anyway, I'm going to put my little switch back together. I'll put a little hot glue in here. And I have my little Sharpie probe, 1 megohm probe, so really no need to go on eBay or anything and spend a bunch of high dollars on these probes. There's nothing to them. So, you can build your own. And that's it. I think this thing is back, you know, I noticed going from the low ranges to the high ranges on AC and DC, it is off just a bit, but like Banderson TV said, if you're going to use this just to test deflection for the highest deflection, it really doesn't make any difference when you're doing an alignment on a radio, just so you can see the deflection. So it's really close. I mean, I didn't have to replace any resistors. There are a few that are right on the edge of tolerance, but I left them because they're not out of tolerance. And if I changed those, we could probably pull this thing back in. I mean, but for what it's going to be used for, it's good to go. So that's it. Let me just show you. I have an advanced VoltOhmyst. And if you're interested in that, I might pull that down and take a look at it. Now, this one has four tubes in it. Then I've got this one. This one's in really bad shape. It's a Sylvania. It's called a Sylvania polymeter. There it is, type 134. I was going to try to get this working, but I don't know. It's in pretty bad shape. And I have a Knight. Let's see a model. It's a VTVM. And this one also has four tubes in it. So I don't know if that's an older model or a newer one that's more accurate. Not quite sure. If you know, have any comments, put them right down here, will you? I appreciate it. Okay. Well, that's it. We'll see you next time. N0JRJ. This is George. Bye-bye.